Okay, we're going to turn now to that terrifying kidnapping near Atlanta. Ivani Perez is back with her family this morning after being abducted at gunpoint from her home. Two suspects have been arrested, but police are also investigating a connection to the girl's family. NBC's Gio Benitez has been tracking the case, and he's here with the latest developments. Good morning, Gio.
Good morning, George. A confusing one, no doubt. Police say this all apparently started as a random home invasion where two armed men demanded money, then abducted the girl. This morning, investigators say she's in good health, but even with two men arrested, police are still searching for others. This morning, investigators are frantically hunting for these two men, who they say kidnapped 14-year-old Ivani Perez and who they now believe are on the run. Even as friends of the teen, who was found safely Wednesday, were greeting her at her home outside of Atlanta.
There are several other suspects that we are still investigating.
She's home, she's safe, and that's what really matters.
Police aren't saying much about how they found Perez, only that they found the 14-year-old nearly 26 miles from home. Police will say that they arrested 29-year-old Wildrego Jackson on kidnapping charges and 40-year-old Juan Alberto Contreras Rodriguez, a Mexican national, on immigration violations. But as this community celebrates the teen's safe return this morning, they are also asking questions. Court records show that one of the men charged, Contreras Rodriguez, and the 14-year-old's mother were arrested on drug charges the same day in February of 2012. In news reports at the time, police said they were busted as part of a marijuana trafficking ring. The charges against both were later dropped.
So this case has these two odd things going on inside it. One, a relationship between the mother and one of the abductors. And is this even a logical house to break into?
But to Perez's family and friends, none of that seems to matter right now. This morning, neighbors who have seen her say she's smiling and happy to be home.
I said to her, I want you to know that I've been praying for you and I knew that God would come through. And she said, thank you.
And police are staying quiet on this case. And this morning, they're not telling us anything about any possible motive. But thank goodness that little girl is okay.
That's all that matters.
Yeah. Okay, Gio, thanks very much.
All right, George, now to a decade.